The internet is full of bro science, fake knowledge, half information or propaganda. Your quest of reliable, authentic health information ends here. So subscribe this channel and hit the bell icon and you never have to go anywhere else ever again.
Hello everyone, how are you today? I'm Dr. Paramjeet and we are going to talk about suntan removal today. We've already talked how suntan happens and how can you prevent that, why skin protection is very important. Today we are going to talk about how you can actually remove the suntan if it already happened, right? So most importantly, you have to remember, if you keep on going back into the sun, nothing is going to work and suntan will rather increase, and you will have permanent pigmentations, even melasma can develop, and that will not go away if you keep on going into the sun without protection. So first basic thing here is sun protection, which you have to make sure you're doing properly. So once you go, stop going out in the sun, once you do sun protection, the suntan actually goes away by on its own over time. Yes, it takes 2 weeks, 3 weeks, maximum 4 weeks, and suntan will go away, but in that time you have to make sure that you are out of the sun, right? And you are taking care of the skin. Basic skincare routine: you have to cleanse your skin, toner, you have to use a cleanser, toner, moisturizer and a sunblock on a daily basis, and you'll be fine according to your skin type, of course, and proper hydration and proper diet, balanced diet is important. Apart from that, what are the basics? What are the things which you can use to remove your tan? First thing is a basic, what kind of magical serums and tubes and lotions and face wash and etc, etc. I won't tell you the face washes, I'll tell you what are the basic ingredients, what are the effective things which work in those things. That basically these have very light skin bleaching agents like vitamin C or some antioxidants, like basically these are there, and some beta carotenes or other things are there to skin lighten the upper layer of the skin, right? That's the same thing which is there in the potatoes and the other natural things which people use, even papayas and other fruit-based masks and other things work like this only, right? Even the doctors have effective mask, oxygen infusing mask, vitamin C serum infusion mask, which are available in the dermatologists with dermatologists for the treatment. So first things are the serums, the basic magical serums which you can use. Yes, if you apply vitamin C serum on the affected area on the tan 2 to 3 times a day, the superficial skin layer will get detanned, right? Or very soon, that right? It will get detoned, what you can say. And obviously you have to have all these things in the diet as well. You have to add vitamin C, fruits, basically they will give you all the vitamins, antioxidants, and these will prevent your skin to react further from the sun and increase the tan. Obviously they will help you get rid of the tan also, right? Then there are some people who want to go for home remedies. Home remedies do work. For example, you can use something called as gram flor, which is called besan in Hindi, which you can use besan with milk, right? Gram flor with milk, which can be applied on the affected area, and it actually helps to remove the superficial layer of the skin as well as detan it, right? And the next local therapy which you can use is honey with some sugar and turmeric. That also can be applied and left over on that area, because sugar has glycolic acid and that also acts as a mini peel. So make that also gives you a superficial layer removal, and that's also good. And even sugar, if you keep on rubbing it, it can also act as a physical exfoliate, right? So that's how these things work. And then some people, they develop actual pigmentation, actual melasma. For them, they need to go for chemical peels. Chemical peels are done by trained dermatologists only. They might use alpha hydroxyl acid, glycolic acid, salicylic acid, lactic acid, etc. So many things are available in the dermatologist. For that, you should not experiment on yourself. Go to a dermatologist. It's safe only in their hands, right? And the most important step here is hydration, proper diet, proper drinking of water, and saving yourself from the exposure of the sun. And again, remember, there is a skin routine. You have to do cleansing, toning, moisturizing, and then sunblock. This is important. If you don't do this, if you don't protect yourself, nothing is going to be permanent. And your sun damage, your sun tan, your sun melasma, whatever it is you're treating, will come back. So this is the basic. Hope you like the video, share it, and get back again for similar videos. I'm Dr. Paranjit. You're watching Dr. Education. Stay connected, stay healthy.